and providing valuable views to the panel in the last year.
Honorable Frankie Yick will address the Council on the report of the panel on transport 2017-18. Honorable Frankie Yick. President, in my capacity as the chairman of the panel on transport, I submit the report on the work of the panel for this year and outline several major areas of work. The panel continues to closely monitor government policies related to transport and issues of public concern during the current session. In the current session, the Subcommittee on Matters Relating to Railways under the panel have also continued to follow on matters related to railway planning, the implementation of railway project under construction, as well as the monitoring of existing railway operations. In May 2018, the panel was briefed on the MTRCL fare adjustment for 2018, which would be implemented in accordance with the fare adjustment mechanism as reviewed in 2017. According to MTRCL, the overall fare adjustment rate for MTR fares in 2018-19 came to 3.14%. Members were generally dissatisfied that the MTRCL will increase the fares according to FAM despite its hefty profits. The panel noted that upon the implementation of the new fares, MTRCL will provide the 3% rebate to Octopus users for at least 6 months. Members in general considered that more fare concessions should be offered to passengers. The panel has all along been paying attention to the progress of the construction of the Hong Kong-Zhuhai-Macau Bridge and the transport arrangements after its commissioning. In May 2018, the panel was consulted on the operation arrangements for the HCMB Bridge and the Hong Kong Port. The panel was also consulted on the raft of large-scale transport infrastructure, such as the construction of the Cheung Kuan O Cross Bay Link, widening of the Taipei Road Shaxin section, etc. Members offered suggestions on how to expedite the progress on construction on the proper adoption of mitigation measures in order to minimize the noise impact and air pollution caused to nearby residents. In the current session, the panel continued to follow up on the issues of acute parking space shortage and the progress of measures implementation under the public transport strategy study, and held public hearings to collect the views of the public, while proposing effective improvement measures to the administration. Furthermore, the panel was consulted on the public transport fare subsidy scheme, the league amendments on enhancing the safety requirements of roadworks, and the implementation of new generation on-street parking meter system. Besides expressing support, members also proactively offered their views for administration's consideration. The written support report has given a detailed account of the work of the panel in other areas. President, I so submit. Dr. Honorable Chang will address the Council on the report of the panel on education 2017-18. Dr. Honorable Chang Lai Wan. President, in my